president, of course, at the height of excitement associated with his victory in 2013, was quite elated and did point out, and I quote him, "We'll not settle for a perfunctory peace that is disrupted every 5 years by an election cycle. Rather, we are calling and working toward permanent peace." Those were the remarks of His Excellency President Uhuru Kenyatta on the 9th of April 2013, when he was taking over the reins of power as the chief executive of this republic. Those remarks juxtaposed against what the president was saying when he was dismissive of the truth, justice, and reconciliation process points to a split personality. We have had a president who is haunted by the rear mirror. You have had him question why people should not concentrate moving forward as you drive. Why look at the rear mirror all the time? And I think it is because he sees some ghosts that are only visible to him, but not to the rest of us. And so I felt that rather than talk about commitments that contending political parties and candidates have made in the run-up to 2017 elections, perhaps we need to go back a little bit behind and ask whether we have held President Uhuru to account on his commitments to look for lasting peace. And that, for me, is with respect to the implementation of the Truth, Justice and Reconciliation Report. Countries that have had the courage. I think one of the problems we suffer in this country is our inability to muster enough courage and confront our dirty past. I'm saying this because I'm quite alive to the ongoing debate about secession, which the Attorney General has described as unconstitutional. Yet the Attorney General, one of the functions of the Attorney General, is to uphold the rule of law and defend public interest. Kenyans are questioning, and it is within their constitutional right, to ask whether this enterprise called Kenya is a reality or a theory just in the Constitution. I want to dispel this notion that, you know, this debate about secession is unconstitutional. In fact, the AG stopped short of saying it is treasonable. If you read Article 255 of the Constitution that contemplates amendment of the very Constitution, it says that one of the things that would require referendum is any amendment to the Constitution that affects the Kenyan territory. So if the Constitution itself contemplates its own amendment with respect to the territory, it means that it is within the constitutional right of anybody, any segment of this society, to question loudly or reflect upon quietly whether they want to be part of this enterprise. And Mombasa Republican Council should be seen within that context. People are constitutionally allowed under 255 to think of seceding and questioning whether they are really part of Kenya. Yet, if we do not hold people to account, because this constitution requires us to protect it, protection of the constitution is a national duty placed upon each and every citizen by the very constitution itself. So we must be, as the civil society, at the forefront, defending any member of Mombasa Republican Council, any member of any society that is engaging in the ongoing debate about secession. Because for me, that debate raises a very fundamental point. That republic, as contemplated in Article 5 of the Constitution, is premised on the values and principles of governance in Article 10. And so what those who are talking about secession are reminding us is that if we are going to be Kenyan outside the framework of the national values and principles of governance, then we are not ready to be part of that republic. And the national values and principles of governance is about the rule of law. It's about respect for human rights. It is about public participation in the management of public affairs. So if all these are being breached left, center, and right, it is my contention and reflection and considered view that any Kenyan, in small or big numbers, are at liberty to discuss and consider proposing a referendum question as to whether they want to parade. And that is why we publish this book jointly with KHRC. Know your rights as a civil society organization. You must not just know, but defend those rights when they are under attack. Thank you very much.